Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Destiny. If you didn't already know, it's September 1st. I was gonna make this video like a few days ago, but I was still reading, so I was like, let me finish this book so it could actually be a part of the August reading. So it's September 1st and I finished my books. Ooh. Let me take this off. My edges are a bit bad, but we're gonna ignore it. This is the last day you're gonna be seeing me in this hair. Don't even worry about it. As you can tell by the title, this is my August reading wrap up. Since this is the first month I got back into reading, I read almost all or majority of TikTok's most viral books that everyone keeps talking about. So let's just get on with the video. So according to my Goodreads, because every time I read a book, I write a review on it. If you wanna know what currently I'm reading or what reviews I have on some of the books, follow me on Goodreads. My name should just be Destiny Cazeau. This month, according to my Goodreads, I read 10 books. Some I did not finish because it was just really bad to me, but I'm going to take that as like I read it. I didn't read it, but I read it. Some are going to be hard copy books and some are going to be on my phone. When I started reading, I didn't realize how broke I was. I did the free trial of Kindle Unlimited for 30 days, so I had some hard copies for me to start reading, and then when I ran out of my hard copies, I went online on Kindle and started reading books. So I'm gonna tell you guys the books that I read from order, from what I read first to my last book, and then also my ratings on the books. Let's get started. All right, so the first book I read for August, I think I started this literally on August 1st, The Witch Collector. I think this book took me, since it's my first book, it's the longest like I took to read a book. To be honest, this took me 3 days to read, and which is crazy because now that I look back like on some of the books I read now, it doesn't take me this long to read a book. This book is literally, how many pages? 343 pages, which is really crazy because I don't read 343 pages in 3 days. Like, that's 100 pages a day. I don't do that. I literally finish like 400 or 500 pages in a day sometimes. And I'm kind of biased towards this book because since this is the first book I read to get me out of a reading slump, the last time I read was like in high school, in like ninth grade from Wattpad. I was a crazy reader from Wattpad in like middle school and stuff, but the last time I actually read a book was from ninth grade. So this is the first book that got me out of a reading slump. It's my favorite book, and I still haven't found a book that topped it yet. To be honest, I have a review on TikTok, so I'll just put it up right here. In honor of the author of my favorite book following me, I'm gonna do a review. No one talks about this book on Booktok enough, but I guess it's because it's fairly new, but y'all need to hurry up. This was the first book I read to get myself out of a reading slump, and I still have not read a book that topped it yet. When I tell you I'm obsessed with this book, I'm obsessed with this book. This book is about a mute witch, which basically means she can't speak, which I literally loved. There's a witch collector named Alexis, and he collects witches every single year to serve under the Frost King. One day he finally chooses Reyna, and they go on a journey together, and the tension is crazy. The tension is crazy. There hasn't been a single time in this book where I had to put it down and I was like, I'm not reading it. It's annoying. The main character is so badass and Alexis is so badass that it's like, I've never seen this before. I'm trying to explain this book without spoiling it, but I literally can't. I'm so excited for the second book, which is City of Ruin. It comes out September 27th and y'all already know I'm gonna be all over that book. If you're looking for a fantasy romance book, this is the one. Go buy it, read it, and then let me know what you think. This book was not annoying. There was not one part or one like scene or anything that made me want to put this book down. She can't speak, so she speaks in like sign language. I thought I wasn't gonna like it because there's no actual dialogue between the characters, but there are dialogues. Like, she's literally talking like a regular person. I don't know. This book was literally so perfect to me. The male main character, Alexis, oh my gosh, he is so cute. Like, all the like the fan art and like the way his personality is. The trope of this book is basically enemies to lovers, which I eat that up if it's done right. I eat enemies to lovers up if it's done right. I've read some of these enemies to lovers books and they still haven't topped this because it's just not done right. Enemies to lovers is basically I'm supposed to kill you to lovers. It's also one horse trope. I think they had like two horses and then they switched to one. So there's like a one horse trope, forced proximity. I'm just gonna put a screenshot of my review right here. If you wanna get into reading and you like fantasy, this is the book you need to read. First of all, this is so pretty, and then the second book is so freaking pretty as well. I rated this one 5 stars, and I had to change some of my ratings on Goodreads because this was my first book, so I basically didn't know what a 5-star book was, but now that I'm reading other books, I can now have a good interpretation of what a 5-star book is. With BookTok people, they always rate something 5 stars. You go into the book expecting it to be 5 stars, and not everyone reads the same or has the same taste and stuff. So I'm not gonna rate something 5 stars, even though it's kind of like 5 stars for me, but I'll rate it 4.5 stars. Because if I say 4.5 stars, people will literally like understand, okay, maybe there's something wrong with the book that I won't like, you know? So they'll go into the book not expecting a 5-star book. I didn't read this book, but I bought it with The Witch Collector, and it's sitting in my bookshelf collecting dust. The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. I wanna read it because people say it's so emotional and it's so good, but like, I just can't get into it. I like action, I like story, like an actual storyline. It just doesn't sit well with me. The next book I read right after that, A Touch of Darkness. This book is a Hades and Persephone retelling. So basically it's like Greek mythology with gods, goddesses, and I eat that stuff up. I literally love it. So it's not an enemies to lovers, but it's like I'm supposed to not like you trope. Like, it's not like she hates him, but she just hates how he deals with things. Like, everyone knows you're basically supposed to hate Hades because he's portrayed as a bad person. This book is definitely up there in one of my tops. It's not a 5-star, but it's like a 4.5 star. I read this book in a day. All right, so there are 379 pages in this book, and I read this in a day. So that's why I'm saying that with this, The Witch Collector, this one was kind of like I ran through this really slow because it was my first book, but as soon as I got into it, I read a 380 page book in a day. After A Touch of Darkness, I bought A Touch of Ruin, but I have not read this yet because I am scared. BookTok told me that this book is really annoying. I just don't want to cross that path because I feel like if this book is annoying, I'm going to stop reading. Third book I read this month was, this one was on my Kindle because I didn't have money and I didn't want to go out and buy the book, which I really should because I love the cover. It's called City of Thorns, and then I read the second book to City of Thorns, which is Lord of Embers. I think there's a third book, but I stopped after Lord of Embers just because it just wasn't doing it for me. City of Thorns wasn't a bad book. I rated it a 3-star. I said this book definitely has a really good plot. I also love the way it ended on a cliffhanger, and I love cliffhanger books. The writing isn't the best, but it's definitely still readable. The writing was giving Wattpad. The guy like got heartbroken by this one lady that locked him up when he was younger or back in the day, and then he found a girl that was literally her doppelganger, and it was crazy. Like, this is an enemies to lovers book, a very like I'm going to kill you enemies to lovers book, and has fake dating, like a very small fake dating. Like, it's not like they say they're dating, but it's like people around them know that they're, you know, messing with each other. So I rated that one 3 stars, and then I rated the second book 2 stars. I think that one got really repetitive, and there was just, the plot wasn't moving along. Like, it was still a good book, but I just don't like the way it ended. The next book I read after those 2 books, so right now we're at 4 books. If you guys know what the chili peppers mean and stuff like that on TikTok, and you want to read a book like that, this is the book. So I kind of knew what to expect, but I thought there was gonna be more to the story. This was literally just like chili peppers. This book has 583 pages. I forced myself to read this book. The morals of the main male character just didn't line up. This book is about a girl. She's an author, and she just moved into this house that used to be her grandma's, which she got murdered in that house. She got murdered by apparently her stalker in that house. This girl moved into that house named Adeline, or Adeline or whatever. She moved into that house, and then she got a stalker, which is a weird coincidence. That stalker is like totally in love with her just off of like looking at her once at like a book fair or something like that. And then he just basically stalks her the whole book. He kills people for her and does all that stuff, which I was like, love that. Like, I love a good book that's like, oh, touch her, I'll kill you. Okay, this is not big of a spoil. Like, you find out like in the first 2 chapters, so it's not big of a spoil. Male main character kills pedophiles for a living. Anytime he finds a pedophile, like whether it's in the government, the system or whatever, he kills them. And he says it's wrong, which it is wrong, but then he goes out and stalks the female main character. The trigger warnings on this book, oh my gosh, I'm not even telling you guys about the trigger warnings. If you want to read this book, you need to search up trigger warnings, because this has like the big R word. He killed people for like doing bad things, but he did basically almost the same thing. I rated this book 2 stars. The next book I started reading, which is the first book I actually annotated, which is Terms and Conditions. If you watched my other videos, you would see me trying to annotate this book. I'm trying to block the sun. It's really pretty. I love annotating my books, and I'm going to start doing that more. Terms and Condition, I rated it 5 stars, but I'm gonna go back on Goodreads and change it to a 4-star. This book was 466 pages, and I read this in a day. I did like it. I love the plot. This was a marriage of convenience, a workplace romance. So basically, her boss and she's the assistant. She has to marry her boss to help him get his inheritance and own the company and all that stuff. He is a grumpy and she's a sunshine. This is also forced proximity because they had to start living together, and then there's also like jealousy in this book. The only reason I rated this 4 stars was only because I'm a strong fantasy person and this is not a fantasy book. I also love this book because Iris is a black woman. It's an interracial book. I love that. Declan towards the end of the book was the most like chef's kiss ever. This is the second book to the Dreamland Billionaire series. Go read Terms and Conditions. This was really, really good. This was a popular TikTok book as well. We're on to From Blood and Ash. I've been waiting to read this book for so long. Like, I kept pushing it off because of the reviews. They said that this is a knockoff ACOTAR. I literally loved From Blood and Ash. It was a really good book, so I would rate this book 4.5 stars. This book is basically about a maiden who is the chosen one of a kingdom, and she's not allowed to like talk to anybody. She has a veil over her face. No one knows what she looks like except for like a few, like 5 people in the kingdom. She was just raised differently and isolated. Basically, she meets this guy, and this guy is like the sweetest person to her. He like makes her feel herself and lets her feel free and lets her do whatever she wants. I was team him until the very end of the book. Their love story throughout the book was really, really good, and I loved it until the end of the freaking book. The way this book was going, I was like, okay, this could be a standalone. Nope. The next book I read was Kingdom of Flesh and Fire. The way it ended, I couldn't just stop it and not read this. I picked up the book fast as heck. This book was 558 pages, and this one was a little less. I think it was like 400 something pages. This literally ended on a really strong cliffhanger, so I had to read the second book. I'm okay with this book. I'm gonna change From Blood and Ash. On Goodreads, I have it as a 5-star, but I'm gonna change it to a 4-star. And then for Kingdom of Flesh and Fire, I'm going to do 4 stars. I'm gonna do 4 stars because if you can see my tabs, nothing really happened the first part of the book. Nothing happens. Like, there was nothing emotionally. This was literally just filling up the like questions in the first book, and this was all basically world building. Those are all my physical copies that I have of the books that I read, but I still have books that I read on my phone. The next book I read was Twisted Love. I did not finish that. If you guys could convince me that the Twisted series is worth it, I will read it. But no shame to the author. Like, I heard she's really nice, really sweet. It's just the writing, I just couldn't. This book is about a girl, and she has a brother who has a best friend. So this is like brother's best friend type of trope. And it's supposed to be an enemies to lovers trope, but it wasn't crazy enemies to lovers. Like, it was barely enemies to lovers. Like, it was enemies for like the first chapter. And then the second chapter, they were like friends, like decent friends. Everything was just moving a little bit too fast, and I just couldn't. And then the last book I read this month is The Predator by Runix. I read that August 27th to August 27th. This is not like a fantasy book. This is a gang rivalry. A girl from one gang and a guy from one gang, they basically team up together to like destroy some codes that the girl made, but that is now out in the universe. I think I'm gonna change my rating to 3, but it quenched my desire for a toxic book. If you guys know books like this, let me know and leave it down in the comments, because I'm still looking for books that are like toxic and stuff, and I can't find the right toxic book. So the toxic I'm looking for, they like each other, but the guy gets like strong, jealous, like over anything. I don't want a toxic book that says it's toxic and it's not even toxic. It's just like relationship problems, you know? And I'm not a toxic person, but that's what's something that's gonna keep me on my toes and to continue reading and stuff like that. That is my August reading roundup, wrap up. however, whatever y'all say. If you guys like this video, even if you guys don't like this video, I think my channel is gonna turn into like a reading channel, a book channel. I'm so excited. Like, I want reading to be my job at this point, but it will be my job. If y'all like this video, leave a like and comment down below so we could turn this into my job, and I'll learn how to review better. I will give you my honest reviews on books, and the more I read, the more I'll know what I'm looking for in books, and I'll explain it better, and then I'll tell you what's worth it and what you should read first and all that stuff. Don't forget to subscribe if you did like this video. Don't just like the video and not subscribe. Like, come on, we have thousands of books to read. You need to be a part of this. Hope you guys have a nice day. I'm about to take a thumbnail and I'm gonna take a nap. Bye.